Hello students, today I am here to explain you about the first chapter of class 2 English. The name of the poem is Comparisons, written by Catherine A. Morin. The poem is about the comparison. Comparison means to think of what is same or different between two things or two people. Here, the comparisons are two types. Number one, different between two things, and number two, similarity between two things. Let's go to the first stanza of the poem. The elephant is very large and I am very small. The elephant is a very big animal or very large animal. All we know that, and I refers here to the poet, and I am very small means the poet is very small. So the elephant is very large and the poet is very small. Here the comparisons are between two things, like the elephant and the poet. So we can say that the elephant is larger than the poet. Next line, the snail might say as much to me, he would think me very tall. We all have seen the snail. Snail lives in water and its body covered with a shell. So the snail is a very small animal, and when it sees to the poet, it must think that the poet is very tall. So here the comparison between the snail and the poet. So we can say that the poet is taller than the snail, or we can say that the snail is smaller or shorter than the poet. The snail is shorter than the poet. Next one says, a rose is to a ladybird a palace grand and sweet. Ladybird means one type of short, small insect or worm. Look at your right side of your book. Here is a picture of a ladybird. To a ladybird, a rose is just like a palace, means just like a very big house or large house. This house is very grand. This house is very great and sweet. So, to a ladybird, a rose is a big house. Next line, as big as houses must appear to the two children in the street. Means, just like the houses are big to the street children, means the street children have small houses, or the street children live in footpaths or in street. So when they see the big houses, they think that the big houses are just like palaces. So here the comparison has a similarity. Just like a rose is a palace to a ladybird, just like the houses are big to the street children. Here the similarity is between two things. What are the two things? The ladybird and the street children. Because a ladybird, to a ladybird, a rose is a palace, and to the street children, big houses are like palaces. Next stanza, and stars that look so wee are big, some bigger than the sun. Means we look the stars are very small. So we means they are very small. and but the stars are big and some are bigger than the sun. All we know that some stars are bigger than the sun. So here the comparison is between the stars and the sun. So some stars are bigger than the sun. And next line. And yet they sprinkle all the sky like currants in a bun. Means yet they sprinkle. Yet means even. They means the stars. Sprinkle means spread or scatter. So the stars even scattered or spread all over the sky like currants in a bun. Bun means one type of sweet bread or cake type something. And currants mean small dried grapes. In a bun, in a cake, there are many small dried grapes. Like that, all over the sky, there are many stars spread here and there. So here the comparison has a similarity. Just like in a bun there are many currants and all over the sky there are many stars. So here the similarity is between currants and stars, because they all over are all spread or through here and there. Next one is next stanza. And though I am really 7 years old, so large compared with me, means I am means here the poet herself. The poet is really means actually 7 years old. The poet's real age is 7 years old. She is so large means she is so younger. And compared with me means here, the poet here compared, the comparison is between here, the poet and the poet herself. The poet here compared with herself. With me means with herself. Is daddy's car. When I get down, I feel I am scarcely 3. Means when the poet gets down from her daddy's car or father's car, she feels that she is just 3 years old. Here, the comparison is between two things, the poet's reality and the poet's imagination. In reality, the poet is 7 years old, but when she imagines or when she thinks that she moves to a lower position or she gets down from her father's car, she feels just like 3 years old. Okay, students, that's all for today. Thank you.